We're in conversation with Fabrice Cambolive, the chairman of the Asia, Middle East and India region for the Renault Group. Mr. Cambolive, thank you for talking to us. Auto Expo over here. Obviously, design is a very big theme for Renault, looking at all your products around the stall. So is this something which you kind of are defining the brand with in India?
I think that when we are looking at which cars are there today, when I see, when I'm looking at Capture, when I'm looking at Trésor, when I'm looking at Gotham, which is a project, by the way, developed by an Indian local team, everything is focused on design and on innovation in terms of design. Why? Because on one hand, it's pure design, but on the other hand, it's design with functionality. I think when we see what Renault did in India in the last 5 years, we are very young in India actually, but at the same time very well-known because we succeeded to launch two cars, Kwid and Duster, or Duster and then Kwid, which not only have been pioneer in a specific segment for specific needs in India, but also references in terms of design. And what we are doing now with this history, we try to convert it in our next product plan, beginning, of course, with the recently launched model Capture.
But coming to the Capture, to be honest, it's really not been that successful. It was aggressively priced, but it's not got the numbers. What do you think the reason is? Do you think a crossover styling in India sometimes is, you know, market is not ready for it? Why do you think the Capture hasn't really given you the volumes you wanted?
First of all, we are beginning in a new segment with Capture. We had this role of pioneer with Duster, and now we have to prove the complementarity between both cars. I think Capture is bringing modernity, is bringing design, is bringing a design which is different from the code what we can see in the SUV segment, and that's why we need time. We are pretty confident, we are pretty sure about the product, which is good, and which this has been proven by the success of Capture in different markets like Russia, like Brazil, and I think we have just to work to show the car, to show all the product features which will enable us to transfer this good product into a commercial success. But for that, no panic, I think we need time, and we will use this time to work on that.
So what you're saying is you need time, but you're not happy with the numbers right now, are you?
You know, after 2 months of launch, I don't know if it's justified to comment numbers, because we can comment inquiries, booking, yeah, sales, and so on. Just let us a few months to demonstrate that Capture is entering in the Indian market.
But you're confident of numbers?
Yes, I'm very confident on numbers.
Okay, and you know, let's talking about going forward. Obviously, you talked about coming into new segments. What can we expect? Because I think you've got a new model coming in 2019 as well, which again is going to be on the Kwid platform. So what can we expect from Renault in terms of newer products?
I think India is one of our strategic piece in the success of our medium-term plan, okay? And for that, I think what is important in India is, first of all, to be local. That's why we've got two design centers, which is a uniqueness, I would say, among the Renault world. First of all, we've got, of course, a high modern manufacturing plant. We've got also a very important technological center, and those three elements enable us to have a very offensive product strategy in India for the next years. It begins each year, it will convert, this strategy will be converted each year with a launch of a new product, which is targeting a specific segment in India. Next one will be in 2019. I can't now, of course, reveal the secrets of our targeting, but I can assure you that this model we will launch in 2019 will be in a new segment with a new concept and, I would say, a big innovation in terms of roominess.
And, you know, let's talk about the EV space because, again, you're showing the Zoe over here. Can we expect an affordable EV in the Indian market from Renault sometime? And if that happens, when would that be? In the next 5 years, 6 years, 2025, what's the kind of time frame for an EV that people can afford?
First of all, we are following with a lot of attention to the government direction who took India in terms of EV strategy. And I think we are very aligned with this direction, which is, for me, in India, the right one. Second point, you know that Renault, in terms of EV, has a consequent experience. First of all, we are number one in Europe. Each one car, we've got 25% of the market in Europe. Second point, we are developing affordable EV in some other countries now. And of course, we are looking what we could take from these learnings in India to adjust our EV strategy to the potential growth of this segment. It means, for me, in the coming 2-3 years, we will be able to come here in India with a highly integrated EV offer, and that's what we are seeking for, looking at what will happen now in India for the next years.
The thing is, you know, the Kwid in China, that's going to be electrified from what we hear. So could we, I'm putting it very plainly, could we see an electrified Kwid at some point? Because in China, that's something that's being seriously worked on.
I think everything is possible. We have first to see what will happen in China, and more than that, what will happen in India in terms of infrastructure, capacity to deliver electricity everywhere, and so on and so on. I can't tell you now it will happen. I just say it's possible.
Right.
It's doable. And if we decide to do it, we will come with that.
And you know, just looking at your model portfolio, you've got the Kwid family, then you've got cars on the M0 platform, and there's a big white space in between. So is that something that you are also looking at? Because the CMFA, the CMFA Plus, which is also happening, is that something which is a bit of a not decided, or have you developed a strategy to fill that big space between CMFA platform and the M0 platform?
I think that in India, there are still big space everywhere, and we have to grow, but we have to grow with a targeted product. It means what we can see in terms of potential is two way. One potential in terms of best, I would say, size and roominess, which can be a direction. Second direction is, of course, to catch the growth in terms of SUV. It means we are on those two directions, still a lot of place, and we'll play that for the next 2 years.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Thank you.